And we'll convene the Finance Committee meeting at the same time.
I have 2 seconds here. David, did you want to?
Yes.
This is a budget meeting, so I.
I know, real quick. We've been collecting signatures that in opposition to the Sugarloaf condos. And we're getting a lot of comments from people that feel that they're not getting heard, that the plan is too big, their concerns with the water, which wasn't addressed in the peer review. The peer review cannot tell us or the engineering how much water is coming off Mount Sugarloaf. Hence, all their other calculations, I don't know how they made them. The traffic down there, people are absolutely concerned about the traffic. It's going on 180 signatures, okay? Longtime residents, newcomers, I have it all here documented from all the streets in the lower Deerfield area, which is all we have canvassed. The people want to be heard on this. They have their, they want their input and they feel that they're not being heard. That is too large and it's too invasive to the neighborhood in that for too long, we've been kind of brushed aside. And that is just not me anymore. That is 180 people that have taken the time to sign the signature and they're still coming in. Okay, so you want to be heard. You know, you say, come to meetings and be heard. Well, we're trying to be heard and we feel we're not being heard. So you got a couple issues. You can listen to us at the meetings, you can listen to us in the appeal process, or you can listen to us at the ballot box. But these people aren't going away.
David, I appreciate you coming in. I don't want to frustrate you, but the
select board. No, it's more than enough
really
time.
The select board doesn't really have a lot of say in this.
You're the board of health, excuse me. You're
yes.
The board of health.
Yes.
The water on the board of health, okay? The peer review process, as I understand it, the site engineer and the council of governments, the peer review engineer person, she worked the council of governments with Tony Wanseski over on the Brayburn Road project when they looked at that land. That reeks of impartiality, or of not being partial.
Okay. So I would suggest to you that you bring that to this to the planning board meeting on Monday.
Okay.
Okay, because that.
And you're coming in more and more. People are knocking my door down.
Right. Well, that is the actual review board for the project.
But the peer review process on this project was not authentic or whatever term you want to use, okay? They did not look at the water coming off of Mount Sugarloaf. The same water that's going into Eastern Avenue houses, Gray Street houses. I have ladies seldom telling me about the water in their cellar. They want answers before going forward. Water falls on one side of the street, you sump pump it into your lawn. Water falls into that project, it gets special treatment. And by special treatment, it gets put in the overflow and sent down to the sewer.
Actually, that's not true.
Not the sewer, storm drainage.
Thank you.
Storm drainage, but the rest of the residents don't have access to that storm. They have to put it on their lawn and pump it in and out. So you've got a lot of people out there that are very concerned and they feel they're not being heard. Have a good evening. You all do a good job for the town, though. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, David, for coming in. Okay. I do not believe there is any other public comments, so let's get started on the budget.
I guess I'll get a chair. Yes, just everybody duck. Don't take it personally.
Quack.
Just be good at it.
What's happening?
I don't know.
We'll figure that out. Next meeting.
I just didn't have a copy of this. Who's running the meeting?
Well, I was just waiting, Carolyn had...
Yeah, we can be in the story, sorry. So, where would you like to start?
Well, there are two items that, we got Kevin, who I asked to come in at 6:30, and he did, and we were more or less ready, more or less. So, I thought we would like to talk, Finance Committee had had some difficulty with the...
Wastewater treatment?
Wastewater treatment plant, the operations budget. And so, I asked Kevin to come in, and we talked to both of us, and about what the plans were. I just have to find it.
On the expenses, that is the most updated one.
Okay.
Correct.
16 is.
Salaries was updated more recently.
I didn't get one of those.
They're always in your...
Well, I only said that I had a professional do my work on them.
Did you check your mailbox?
It would have been in the very, very back, Article 12.
Oh. It is. It says 10.
Oh, does it? Oh, sorry. My fault.
I already know I don't know what I'm doing this.
Are we going over anything that you went over last night? Because if they don't have it, I'll forget about it.
We didn't go over this one last night, but you want me to go make some copies?
No, I think we're all set.
Are we?
Is that for the...
Do you guys have...
I was just wondering if my copy is what you have.
Same as that one? I hope that's the most recent one. I'm pretty sure.
316.
Does everybody have one of these?
What's the date?
316.
Yes, 502-125 should be your total.
Yeah, wastewater expenses.
Where did Kevin disappear?
Where did Kevin?
I'll be right back.
He's coming right back.
Everybody finally got the page. Now we're ready to go.
He had heard it was approved.
Snooze you lose.
He's gone. He's out of here.
Oh, that's good.
Okay, so how many people don't have a copy?
I don't.
Who else?
Not sure yet.
Two.
Give me one and I'll make a few.
Here.
I don't know if
I got the place one. Two, or unless somebody's got one that's clean.
Here you go. Mine's clean.
Did you say,
okay.
Jeff, what's this for?
52.
Four,
five.
There's not a number on it.
What else is going to do tonight?
502-125.
I think they're going to look at Skims, right?
They're going to look at Skims.
Anything else?
Together?
The church.
I'm going to make a bunch. Of what?
Wastewater.
Okay.
Wastewater expense.
Sure. And we get time, it would be nice to just kind of cover the capital improvement committee.
You know what? Maybe we can just keep the door a little cracked. Can we put a, like, something?
Yeah, I was just trying to. The block isn't big enough.
How about that eraser?
Whose bag is that? Yeah.
Kevin, do you have a copy of your budget?
I believe I do.
Okay.
Kevin, why don't you sneak in?
No, I'm good this way. I can say
spread out.
There's not enough room there.
All right.
Okay, so if I could, I'd like to just really start off the whole thing as this. Really, all depends on what the town and or the sewer committee want to do. I went to the sewer committee last month, being in February, and saying, I can't remember exactly what it was, and said, what am I doing? Which direction should I be going in? And I don't feel that I really got much of a direction. So what I did was I went off of the sewer study that we paid money for and utilized some of the numbers that were on this to input into my budget. Now, This, what I did, is pared down from what the other one actually says, because the other one actually says, this year, we should be at FY18, $701,848.18 is where we should be, quote unquote, going off of the theory of how they were originally looking at to go in this direction. So obviously I saw that and I was like, there's a whole boatload of stuff in there I know we're not gonna do right off the bat. So I ripped them off right off. There are a few things that I kept on there that I wasn't really sure. And if you want, we can go down line by line and we can talk about each one.
Yep.
I guess before we do that, Kevin, can I just ask Bruce and Kip and whoever else was on that? Oh, John and Bruce, you're all on the SOAR committee. What if the study had recommended that the budget be up to 700, what did you all feel about that recommendation? Just in general. I mean, I'm not anything in particular, but did you feel it?
Did the study, you mean just that's
what? That study that we paid for said that the budget should be up to 700. What was,
I assume that they had things that.
That's just general expenses
they
that
wanted to do.
Salary.
Yeah, there was, you know, there's some, like I said, there's some stuff in here that obviously you're not going to do.
If you want my description of what I think the sewer study is, it had no involvement in all of the sewer study committee. We had no involvement at all in that study.
Okay.
We had no input. We were handed a draft of the sewer study about a week before he made a presentation. We had not enough adequate time to review it. We've made subsequent requests of David Pritchard Consulting to review options. We finally have a request that he might like to come, but it's going to sound like he wants more money. Kip will talk to you about that. Right now, we have not finalized any recommendations on rates to the Board of Selectmen. We have several options that we're considering. And our task is not to approve any funding, not in our charter.
Right.
So, and we don't even make a recommendation on the funding.
But do you recommend doing something?
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Where are we at? Where are we at on that? Like, where has that gone anywhere?
Where?
Like, as far as like, where are you thinking?
Where we're thinking, going? Headworks. Reduce the headworks,
yep.
And Captain Lathrop has been the top two priorities at our last meeting.
Yep.
And it would be reduced dramatically. But we need to know, and I have a phone call into Weston and Sampson to determine if they're willing to go forward, since they don't have an engineer in their Rocky Hill office, whether one of the other offices will have the ability to continue and revise the plans as necessary or submit the plans as developed to Mass Works and what the cost might be to that. So that's relative to capital improvements.
Yeah.
We had a chance to review, which we didn't really have to, the INI preliminary draft valuation of what we had in our offices. We felt that if we had the total price, that we would have a better idea of what the total project might be. So I believe we sent it to the selectmen, they approved it. We don't know what the status of that is. That's over 6 weeks old. We have no idea what the status of that specific study is. I think the rate study, if I was to make a recommendation, I would pass it back to the three people that made the input, make a recommendation to the selectmen to accept it or not accept it. That would be my recommendation.
I think going back to the 700,000, I think that report also included a lot of capital expenditures based on a lot more than we are
Anticipated.
And that's why that number was so much higher, because that included the long-range plan of capital with a lot more than we feel it needs. So that's why that is so much higher.
So I'm taking that the consensus is that the not going by the recommended 700 is okay with everybody, right?
Yeah, because that's not even...
That's not even what we're considering.
Right.
At this time.
Right, so we can move on and discuss this now and Kevin's guidelines without any, nobody having an issue, right?
The only issue I have is that they haven't made a public presentation to the public, so the public understands what this sewer study is about. They made a brief discussion with the finance committee, and that's all they've done. They need to make a public presentation by their contract and make a final memorandum.
The sewer study committee?
No.
David Pritchard. Oh, David Pritchard, okay, I see.
And that was part of the contract?
Now, my general understanding is that we've already done that once. When they came up and they put the PowerPoint presentation on.
How many?
Who, David Pritchard?
David Prickett and Tony DeSimone from Weston Sampson.
But who did they do that to? That was the issue?
It was posted and...
Part of the contract was the next step after the draft memorandum.
Okay, yeah, I'm just trying to...
But there was, at the next step, there was a workshop, and they said the workshop, the draft memorandum, and the presentation was made that one evening to the sewer study committee only. And that's not where the contract reads.
Isn't that interesting? The contract's been paid.
Who approved that? We haven't got a final recommendation yet.
Contract's been paid?
I'm sure of it, hasn't it?
Yes.
Completely.
So that's why...
They're gonna walk away from it at this point.
They're not gonna walk away from it. Let's keep this...
They're not gonna walk away from it. They've requested to meet with the sewer study committee and do a workshop, but we're not sure of the benefit of it yet.
I read their comments, and it appeared to me that they were really being nice and beating around the table, but basically, the gist of it was, well, we can do a lot more, but we'll have to talk about expanding the scope of the work and, you know, funding it too. So they're looking for more work.
More money.
More money.
Can I pop in now? Mm-hmm. So my general understanding is, because unfortunately some of a lot of these emails, I'm being completely left out in the cold, so I have no idea what's going on. The only time I'm aware that some of these are going on is when I get an FYI from Dave Prickett saying, this is stuff that's being requested for me, you know, and who are these people to request this? Is it okay? And that's when it was Bruce. I said, yeah, certainly. I says, he asked questions. I says, you know, give him the answers he's looking for. So, and I've been in constant contact with Dave, and Dave is more than willing. He has offered the last three meetings to come up. The last three meetings he offered to come up. And each time we have said we're not quite ready for it because we haven't had our list of questions that we'd like to have answered all at the same time.
Well, didn't you
which was the last email that went out this week.
We sent a list of questions after the first time.
Right.
He said he might would come.
Yep.
So we sent the list of our questions. It was not in everybody's best benefit for him to come and just...
Right.
And
right.
He understood it, and that's
right.
Why he put it.
So
the first meeting was not a meeting that he was going to come to. He requested questions from us. We presented the questions to him. I received the response 2 days ago, when they were dated 6 weeks ago.
Okay.
That's what you sent me?
Yes.
Yeah, but there were responses, but it was really poor. It was beat around the bush, and he made several, in answering several of the questions, he said, see the final paragraph. And the final paragraph was basically, you know, I can do more, but, you know, this it's outside the scope of my original work, so we're going to need more money.
But the original questions...
In any question, could we move on?
Yeah, this is not part of
it.
Okay, no, but it's important that we agree to move ahead.
That part, but the instructions get off of moving.
Sure.
But the questions, at least some of the questions the finance committee have, are all related to those costs.
Okay, well, let's go ahead. As long as we're agreeing to go with Kevin's philosophy here and present this budget.
Well, yes and no. I mean, I still need to know, what do you guys want to do? How where do you want to go?
Sewer commissioners.
I don't know. Well, I thought the the sewer committee should be guiding some form or fashion or some type. I know the recommendation, the final recommendation is not due until December, but.
Our task is not to guide.
Okay, so your task is to.
Evaluate everything we can possibly evaluate, come up with a recommendation to the Board of Health relative to a rate and capital improvements.
So with that being said, that was established last year, so knowing full well we're gonna be having a budget this year, I'm left out, I mean, if you wanna come close to level funding, I can do that, but I have no guarantees what the price is gonna go up to for the next few years, depending on what you wanna do. Because I, once again, I have no idea which direction you wanna go in. But as we go down through this, I will break out some areas. Like, I know one of the questions you have is equipment replacement. You know, with that, yeah, actually it is. It's, it's in whatever you gave to Trevor that he made photocopies of.
Oh, right? That was in our minutes, yes.
Yes, correct. So that was some of the, that was one of the questions you had. So right. With that very particular one was, is I went up to 31,000. And what my problem is right now is, you're right, I should readdress it because I've already overspent 31,000 this year already.
Right.
And I know, because I've got another pump coming in from for the Captain Lathrop lift station, there's another $6,000 right off the bat. So now I'm gonna be close to 8,000 overspent in that one account.
But that line item is specific to pump station maintenance.
That is correct, because how the things are blended together, correct? Correct. So how, where do you guys want to start? And you know, like I said, realistically, I need to know which direction you want to go in.
Maintenance is only maintenance, go ahead.
I think you said we, the sewer committee, is responsible for setting the rate.
No, we are recommendation.
Right, we're responsible for methodology.
Methodology, right. Make a recommendation on what methodology, right. Or methodologies.
Right, but I want to make it clear, we're not.
No, that's right. Correct. You, we're not setting the rate. I apologize.
No, it's just that it's so complicated. That. We felt like we needed a committee to recommend to us what to do, and that, you know, that would go into all the detail.
But it sounds like we're waiting until next year, right?
Yeah.
To get
this year.
Well. December.
December. That was the charge.
Yeah, that was the charge.
So then in the meantime, it's up to the sewer commissions to decide how we want the budget to be?
Yes.
Right.
Well,
and then we'll wait to get an answer from you
in
December.
Want it to be or ought to be?
There
I
go.
Want it to be zero, but
ought to be.
All right, well, let's let Kevin go through this, and then let's try to discuss this with keeping what you might recommend in December, Bruce, okay?
No, because it's different. It's not okay.
Well,
project specific.
Right.
All right. Well, how are we going to approach this so that we
approach
can...
Approach it. Well, Kevin's going to give us a reason why the dollars are the dollars right there.
Yeah.
Yep. Just go through
it. Just like any other budget.
All right. Let's go through it then.
Okay.
So if you would, just sort of line by line.
Yep, that's exactly what we're going.
Why don't we just concentrate on the big difference?
Well,
no, actually, I'd prefer to go line by line, and that way there's no question. Because otherwise, you're going to go from this one, jump back up again, do a line.
No, we're going to go line by line, just so that there's consensus.
Yes, top down.
And everyone agrees that we're going forward, one way or the other. Mm-hmm. Okay.
And so I will say what it is, and then you will ask, then if you have anything to say or questions at that point. If not, then we continue to the next one. Is that fair enough?
Yep.
Sounds good.
All right, clothing allowance. Electricity.
Okay. What is that a realistic number?
Which?
B80,000.
Bear with me half a second. Electricity so far this year, we have used.
Kevin, there is a rate hike, but we signed that contract with
Good Energy, and actually
Good
was
Energy,
down.
And it should be a reduction, actually.
So that's not an increase from the last 2 years?
No. Negative. No, that's been the same since, well, 2016, 2017.
Yep.
Good.
Don't we have solar panels?
Questions? Good.
Yeah.
Third one down, gas, fuel, oil, heating. $13,000, it's been the same, it's the same as last year, went up $3,000 from the year before.
Because $13,000 hit those two buildings?
Yeah, pretty much, yeah. Any other questions? No? Water, it's the same, it's been the same. Actually, it went down. 14 and 15 was $5,000, and in 16, I dropped it to three. So 16, 17 is three, and I'm requesting three again, so that's level funding. Equipment repair, okay, it went from $28,000 to $31,000, and again, as I just spoke a little bit earlier, I have already overspent that account by, as soon as the pump shows up, by about $8,000. I still have a few more months to go. Equipment repair, equipment replacement, I hit the wrong line on it.
Yeah, equipment repair. What have you spent repair. So far?
Equipment repair so far this year.
Does this include your repair work at like Captain Lathrop? Or is this different equipment?
Yes. It's anything. Okay, so I asked for $28,000 last year, and so far I have spent $22,633.
Pretty much. Is that through March, Kevin?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, that is the one that I just
well
got
on track,
like a couple days ago.
Pretty well on track.
So then the next one down from that, and I'm just trying to, because two of them kind of go side by side, $28,000, and again I'm asking for more money. I've already spent $29,151.22, so I'm already over, plus another $6,000 on top of that. So now that's going to put me close to $8,000 over, which if I, basically what I do is when one gets shorted and one's a little more, I steal from Peter to pay Paul, is what I do. Yes, sir.
I know when we viewed the old Deerfield wastewater treatment plant, there was a lot of safety concerns. Are those being addressed?
Some are and some haven't yet. Because
are they in your 18 budgets?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, and some, not all, because one of them is going to be pretty big, because if we go ahead and we replace that stairwell that goes all the way down, that's going to be huge money, because that's all going to be stainless. So that's going to be probably, that's going to be, realistically, that's going to be a capital item.
But the exterior items, all the walkways?
The walkways, those are built into it, that is correct.
And what line item is that?
That would be underneath my repairs.
Oh, Kevin, on both of those, that's all it repairs. It's not just the Captain Lathrop station. It's like,
yeah, that is correct. Both stations. That is correct. That's the pumps. Because he's got issues with pumps down there. Right now, we've got a pump that he cannot use whatsoever. So he's got one tank of a sludge tank that he hasn't been able to use for years. We do actually have somebody coming in from a pump company that's going in to look at the valving to see what we can do. Allegedly, the way they made it sound like is they can come in, cheap money, be able to unbolt this, unbolt one unit, and slide a brand new unit right back in, and the valving would work and it doesn't leak. Because the way it stands right now is when he goes ahead and tries to open up that valve to do the balancing of his tanks,
yep,
the sludge goes all over the floor. Yep. So he can't do that, because obviously it not only is it a mess, but it's a health issue, mm-hmm, pathogen issue, whole nine yards.
Yeah.
So that is one of the things that we're looking at. A couple other things that Keith has some ideas about, but that's, I would prefer to give you that information after we get through this.
Sure.
Now, those items, those major items will come to capital planning?
The major items are going to have to, yeah, because there are going to be big bucks. But again, that kind of goes back to, where are we going, what do we want to do, because some of the things we may be doing, I'm not going to say, because that part of the building is still going to stay. This particular one, when we're talking like the sludge tanks, so spending money there is not going to be a deal of, well, we're going to spend $20,000, but if we go ahead and do the headworks in another 2 years, we're going to throw away that $20,000. That's, by no means am I ever going to try and go down that road. The only time that we're going to spend any extra money that may possibly be replaced by the headworks is purely for operation, to be able to make sure that we stay within code or within
regulations.
Yeah, regulation. Yep. He uses a different word, by permit.
Permit.
Because that's the terminology that they use.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to throw this out right now. Right now, he's having issues keeping permit, basically on a monthly basis, because of how some of the systems work. Old Deerfield, he's having major issues out there, and I'll give Keith huge credit for this, is he was having a huge foam issue, and it was because of the particulates that was going into it. And bear with me, because I don't know 100% exactly what he talks about, but each time I go there, I try and learn more and more. Basically, what's happening is because Deerfield and Bement and the other schools went on vacation, all of a sudden he loses this slug. So the chemical balance within his tanks go haywire. So he ended up coming up with, on his own, and I'm, you know, I know he did some research on the computer, but instead of dumping huge amounts of chemicals in there, which are obviously extremely expensive, he came up with a theory. He spent $152. He came up with some socks and some lava rocks, and he put it into the system, and it worked. It's not a permanent fix by any means, but that kept him from breaking permit. Now, I'm not trying to scare anybody, but I'm going to tell you this just as a basic fact, is if we continually break permit, which we haven't, but if we do, DEP gets involved, and they will say, just like they did in Hatfield, you will spend $10 million within the next 2 years, besides the fines that go along with it, if they issue any fines. So, again, I'm not trying to do a scare tactic, I'm just trying to be real life, and I want everybody well aware, especially people that are watching on TV, that if this goes bad, we're going to have no choice but to do it. So I would prefer to be proactive, because
no,
I would just assume...
No choice to do what?
Say what?
No choice to do what?
To fix the stuff. Because if we start breaking permit all the time, DEP is going to come in and say...
Well, what could we fix?
That's what I'm getting at, is I don't know exactly everything needs to be fixed. Well, I'm just trying to give you an overall of what the possibilities could be.
Right, but as you were saying that, you know, everything was going fine, then all the schools go away.
That was that just particular instance. Right, but he still has problems over here, and it's got nothing to do with schools over here.
Right.
So he has problems at both plants. Yeah. You know, that was just one particular instance I was trying to bring up, that our chief operator used his head, thought about our wallet, and tried to do the best thing he could to resolve the problem that we had without costing us a whole boatload of money. That was the reason why I brought that particular instance up. So that in turn, I kind of went along and said, we have to be cautious about permit. So, which obviously eventually goes back to, where are we going, what are we doing? So, let's see. So are we okay with equipment repair and replacement? It's a 10.71% increase, going from 28,000 to 31,000. Yes, no, buy, sell?
Line.
Next line. Equipment rental. Obviously, equipment rental, I can actually drop down a little bit if you'd like. For the simple fact is we really haven't. We've only used like about $350 worth of that. So I can come back to you realistically and change these numbers.
Kevin, what do you do?
I'm not worried.
If you're already
Kevin.
Over by 6,000 with one pump,
yeah,
I wouldn't bother changing it.
No, no. This is for rental.
So I'm saying
okay, all right, that's fine. Yeah. All right, chlorinator and the meter repairs on level funded. Sewer line maintenance, pumping station. Okay, that went to the 90,000. They were actually estimating 112,000, which was a 16.88% increase. Planning for Captain Lathrop pump station. That right there can be pared down to about. I really wouldn't go less than 80,000 on that. For the simple fact is. We incorporated the pumping station maintenance and sewer line maintenance. I worked with Brenda on this because otherwise this right here would be this long. So we were attempting to go ahead and take some of these and blend them together. Does that make sense?
It's fine with us.
Yeah.
Okay.
You're saying you can live with it.
All right. So in.
So what do you want to put it at?
So I mean, I can go from 90 to 80.
Okay.
Okay, Bruce is saying no. But what I'm doing is I'm just giving you guys options of what I know
saying,
I can probably get away
you
with.
You got $112,000 and you only have 90 in here.
Right.
The question is, do you need the 112,000?
The way it stands right now, no. But that all depends on if we go ahead and do anything with that pump station. But if we do something with the pump station, that's definitely going to be a capital expense. There's no doubt about it.
$2 million capital.
Actually, that's not including the tank. I'm not talking the tank and everything else. I'm talking
for Captain Latham.
That's what we were given the estimate by the engineer.
So let's just put the tank. We'll just pretend the $1 million doesn't exist right now, Kip. So what I need right now would be to replace the panels, replace the electronics, replace the pumps, because we, if we do that, we'd like to go from a single phase to a three phase, which is eventually going to save us money. Right. The three phase is on the street because the phasing is already there. Mm-hmm. And technically, we're supposed to have a generator for anything that's like that. We presently right now do not have a generator. The generator that we do utilize right now is a 1966 military surplus, which kind of works and kind of doesn't work.
Does the generator sit up at... This is a Captain Lathrop, right?
Yeah, this is Captain Lathrop, and this sits in that red barn that's next to... And but to give Mark Gilmore credit, he went ahead and he got his hands on another generator, which is about an 8K generator, which should basically do what we think we need it could do.
Is it going to give you three-phase?
That I couldn't tell you. I believe it does, but I can't tell you for sure.
You guys are going to three phase?
Most smaller generators don't have not three phase.
I have an issue. If you're only dealing with three phase, you're going to pay dearly for a generator of three phase. That's
Okay. Well, this
so is, your savings is going to be a false savings.
It's going to go right out the room. Okay. And that's something that I don't know. So
as far as cost of energy, going three phase, you're going to save 5%.
Not going to save that much. We had that discussion in the last sewer study committee.
Yeah.
So how much of this is related to the issues we keep having at Captain Lane?
Got a seat.
You want?
Well,
they don't
want to
sit through this.
Got a seat.
All right.
Scams. They were supposed to be here at
7. Is that one again?
How much of this is related to the issues we keep having with Captain
Lane? Some of it is. It's the electronics. We're having issues with electronics, with the board, the controls. The pumps themselves, the pumps that we are replacing now with new pumps, have been rebuilt 3 or 4 times already. So they have already gone past their useful life. That's why the last two pumps we bought were brand new. The other ones were refurbished.
Those, you said $6,000 a piece?
$6,000. Myers 3-horse pump, it has to be explosion-proof. The explosion-proof makes it another $2,200. If you went with a non-explosion-proof, which technically you can't do because that's a class 1 system, vapors, then you could save a couple grand. But unfortunately, we can't. Okay. It has to be explosion proof.
So we're at 90?
Yeah. So no, we're going to go down to 80. But
are you sure? Going to 80?
Yeah.
So you know, like I said, you know, I am trying to give you options. Is what I'm trying to do. Personally, myself, I would keep it at 90.
Well, what do you guys
I think you're better off leaving it at 90.
I agree.
The trouble they've had, leave it at 90.
Yeah.
All these costs.
All right, cool. All right, so the next one down from there is lab fees and supplies. I went from 10 to 12. Basically, depending on what it is, some of these lab fees, we're getting an increase. We are looking at other places to see what they could do for fees for our testing. Mm-hmm. This is testing that we're not, by law, we're not allowed to do ourselves. It has to be a third-party testing.
Yep.
And the fees are going up. This one right here, an increase is about 20%. Out of the entire 20%, not all of that is the... lab fees. Some of that is some of the supplies that he's actually having to get. He has to get special little filters and this and that for his daily and weekly inspections of his wastewater. You guys okay with that?
Yep.
All right. Chlorine's going up. I went up $1,000 because chlorine is going up 14.29%. Same thing along with the polymer. Both polymer and chlorine are going up. Fortunately, for the most part, the majority of this numbers right here for the chlorine and the polymer is dedicated to South Deerfield, because obviously we have much more flow through there than we do in Old Deerfield. Mm-hmm. Talking with Keith, he says, you know, realistically, he says the chlorine, he says, we'll go through a little bit more there, but the polymer, realistically, he says he'll only use like maybe one container or one barrel up there compared to arbitrary number 14 or 15 down here. Mm-hmm. Again, arbitrary number. So, any problems with chlorine or polymer?
Nope.
All right, tools and supplies. Tools and supplies, level funded.
What kind of tools and supplies?
Any kind of tools, hand tools. The supplies that go along with it. If we go ahead and we need hand tools. If we need
Tyvek suits, stuff like that.
The Tyvek suits. Because realistically, some of these guys aren't really wearing the Tyvek suits when they should be wearing them. And by the way, I am going to be instituting, actually, I've already purchased them, is we're getting life vests for these guys. When they're going on the...
Thank you.
When they're going on the machine, they're going to be wearing a life vest. There's just no question about it. The simple fact is, if something happens, they go to the bottom.
Yeah.
Being on the dive team, I'm the one that's going to have to go pick them up. And I really don't want to dive in there, so...
Rather catch them when they're floating.
Yeah, it's a lot easier, because we've got the hook. So the other things that go and kind of go along with that, with the tools and supplies. Supplies could be their, the fuel, not the fuels, some of the oils and stuff that they utilize for their lawn care, because they take care of their own lawns. They have their own lawn mowers. They have their hooks. They have, sometimes he buys hoses to change things around. There's just multiple things, and if you like,
is that as a catch-all? How much have you spent in that catch-all for this year?
Tools and supplies this year. I am on through.
How come it never existed before last year?
Did it have any?
It was lumped into another.
All right, so let me give you something real quickie here, because some of these items you're going to see on here that you haven't seen before, and Kip, you weren't around for this when I first started trying to do budgets a couple years ago. In the past, when you look at the budgets, they were really kind of clumped together. And it was, when you looked at something, you went ahead and said, okay, well, technically, we can pull it out of this account. That's not my style. I want to know where the money's going. So that's why I try and break this down as much as possible so I can actually get a true reading of where my money's going. I don't like the theory of stealing from Peter to pay Paul, but there are times that I have to do that, very specifically this year between my repair and my equipment replacement. I have to take from one to be able to cover the other. Now I may end up having to steal it from somewhere else on one of those little line items to go ahead and make sure that that is covered.
So what have we spent so far this?
So far this year, we have spent... Where the hell is it?
Oh, it's the last one on yours.
Front page.
Do you want me to hang on to that and answer those kind of questions? Yeah, Kevin?
She can find it much.
Tools and supplies. So far, I've used about $1,200. But I know he's got a few more things coming up, and if that's something you want to reduce a little bit, we can. Oh, not an issue. You want to drop that down to 1,500 and make that level funded, that's fine.
Yeah, I'll make it, well, no, it's not. It was level funded would be 5,000.
That would be 5 grand.
How about cutting it in half?
2,500?
Yeah. Okay. Anybody got any questions on the next one? $1,800 for licenses, fees, courses? Okay, $32,000 for financial model and IPP coordinated.
$8,000 for IPP rate study updates. If you were to go ahead and do that, there's a possibility of $6,000. Sewer regulations is $14,000, and the NPDSES compliance for our licenses is $4,000. That right there equals up to $32,000.
Any questions?
Nope.
Can we go on?
Well, if we don't do that study.
And what's the next one? $14,000? What's for what?
Okay, so the first one was IPP, yeah. $8,000. $6,000 for the sewer rate updates.
Six.
What sewer rate updates?
That's anticipation that we're going to be doing something. That's part of your engineering.
No, it's for David Pritchard to update the history report.
Right, but again, it's underneath engineering, which I consider all of that engineering.
We're not going to have him do that. So.
Is somebody else going to do it?
Nothing to update. The selectmen are going to set the rate.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So I can drop $6,000 off of that. $14,000 for the
change that to 26.
For sewer regulations, and then the $4,000.
Sewer regulations. Are we writing those?
No, those are the ones that we actually have to abide by. These are some of the things that they have to apply for. That goes along with the NPDES, which is our permit. Mm-hmm.
So we're spending $18,000 on.
Permitting, basically.
But we have last line out of $8,000. $8,000 for permitting.
Because last year you gave $16,000 for engineering only.
Yeah, we didn't spend it all though.
No, so far we've only spent $5,382.76.
Right.
$5,300 what, Kevin?
5382.76. But I still have that money that I, that we, that for 4, the, for the 4,000. So now I'm up to 9,000.
Will that be spent in this fiscal year?
That will be, that has to be spent in this fiscal year, or at least half of that.
Well, I thought the rush was we had to have it all, the study had to be completed so we can.
The study has to be complete by the end of the year, but we needed the information for the flow.
Right.
So right, that should but be a lot, of, a lot of the flows we've already missed so, because we waited so long to approve it.
I mean, I thought we did it in time.
Yeah, no, by the time we actually, because, I mean.
The flows really are just starting now.
You think a true flow is going
to, you
think all of the.
When you get your spring rain,
yeah,
that's when you get your flows up there.
Exactly. And nobody's taking any flows. But we haven't got a contract to do flows. All we had a contract for was to do was evaluation of what we had in-house for some, for existing studies and plans. They were going to present to the sewer commissioners.
We approved that quite some time ago, specifically for, so they would get it in time to do the flows.
Kevin, I was 100%, we rushed it through.
Yeah, right.
So that we would get.
Well, we didn't really rush it through. I mean, realistically, that came to the committee back in.
I know, but the select board voted it so that we wouldn't miss this.
We went to the select board.
It was over a month ago.
We sent it to the committee for no reason, because we don't vote on things.
Right.
Then it went back, we sent it back to the board of selectmen.
They recommended it, and I told you at the next meeting, we voted it that night.
I put it on the agenda so we would not miss this.
Right.
And that wasn't even part of the contract to do the spring flows. The contract was for evaluation of our studies.
Do the studies. Study of the studies.
Study of the studies that we have in-house.
And then he was going to go to DEP and see if they're going to require us to do all these
inflows. Yeah, the extra flows, correct.
All right. Or the evaluation, the manhole, smoke test.
So what happened to our, when we approved it?
I wasn't here. Oh. I didn't start to the end of January.
Likely excuse.
Really?
I don't know what was supposed to happen. We're supposed to go out to bid for something?
No, we approved the money. We approved the money, and the guy was, it was a contract with the bid.
Is this Prickett again or somebody else?
That's correct.
The only contract I'm aware of that happened in my time was the INI.
Yeah, that's the one we're talking about.
And that was afterwards, right?
No, that's what we're talking about.
So he's doing that, isn't he?
It should have been. All it was evaluation of our material.
Didn't it initially contain more than you wanted, and so you were kind of negotiating the scope of work down or something? I'm trying to remember because I'm
not that part.
We haven't seen a second contract for the actual work.
Mm-hmm. All right, so what's
so how
up,
does this
Kevin?
Impact us, Kevin, now? So you're telling me it wasn't done what was done?
Any contracts.
There's a possibility, like you said, there's, you got some flow now, but my understanding, what I was told, the way my general understanding of the whole thing is you have to also include the when the frost is coming out to go along with the flow, because otherwise the flows are indifferent. I'm not sure. I don't know. I'm not an engineer. I can't tell you.
But the frost is still in the ground.
No, most of the time.
Never really had one.
And I was supposed to have a snowstorm.
Well, it wasn't very deep.
Hey guys, we got to get moving here.
Yep.
Yeah.
Okay.
So if you want, I can bring.
Well, I don't know what you're gonna do with the study money, but you might need it. But don't use it; it's gonna go back to free cash. So.
No, it goes back to store reserve fund, but yes.
Store reserve.
Yes. Reserve, which is fine.
Okay.
So do you want to leave that then, Bruce?
26,000.
Yep.
We're gonna go change that to 26.
26.
It's very patient.
Okay.
Next one is $2,400 for whatever line we're on.
Mailing.
Any questions?
No.
$1,600 for software maintenance.
No.
$95,000.
No.
Sludge. Okay.
So it's supposed to go down.
Oh, wait.
Actually, you know, it's not really going down that much.
Is Montague
back? Montague's back, but they're not taking all of our stuff because they can't take it all, for one. For two, their rate per dry pound is much higher than it is down in Cranston, Rhode Island. Oh. So we're saving some money transporting there, but we're paying more money for the dry tonnage.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So now if...
We can be better with next year.
Okay, infiltration and inflow...
INI. Okay, presently right now I have not spent any money. I still have the $25,000. Again, because this is the INI quote-unquote season, where we're going to end up paying for the smoke testing, the manhole inspections, the sewer line documentation, the, oh Christ, what else was it? Did I already say the flows?
No.
The flows, what else am I missing?
That's about it.
That's about it.
But we...
So realistically...
The issue is, we don't know whether we're gonna do that or not.
Correct.
Until we finish, David Sidgwick finishes the first report.
Right.
And has he completed that report yet?
That I honestly cannot tell you. I can find out tomorrow about it.
Because he's supposed to make recommendations.
So why would there be a doubling of Kevin?
Let's see, the way I've got it written out here, the explanation to me was, is phase one was $25,000, phase two's $25,000, INI task for state, for state's 2017 INI requirements.
So the 50 is required?
Well, the 50 may not be required because we didn't spend the first 25. But again, this is all, this was all theories put together.
All right, if we don't spend this, this goes back to the sewer reverse reserve. So let's just keep this in here in case.
But we might end up paying a penalty if we don't start getting stuff worked done.
But we need the money in any event.
Yep, we need it one way or the other.
The next three, 1300, 1500, 1500, any questions on those three?
No.
The last one, 8,000, or the next to the last one, $8,000.
Yeah, it seemed like a repeat.
Kevin, is that a different charge or a different permit?
I'm looking, can you have a second?
Should be one of your last ones.
That's gotta be a repeat.
So...
Because if we're utilizing that, because...
In the 90,000, 50,000.
No, in the 26,000.
$26,000.
Okay.
So, what do you want to do with this item?
So, historically in the past, you've always funded that, but again, the other one, the consulting and the IPP coordination, which is actually part of your permitting process, permitting and filing. If you want, at this point, either we can bring it down to 5,500, or you can scratch it all together, and worst case is if I run short at the end of the year, then I dip into reserves. But every time I dip into reserves, it's money that.
But this is the and this is the permit, nothing to do with INI. This is just a
that is correct.
Plant permit.
Correct. Which technically is actually part of your NP.
I understand that.
Yes. Okay.
I don't know why that was included up there, but that's okay. I mean,
so. Yeah. Do you want 8,000? Do you want 5,000? Do you want
if
something
you give
else?
Give me 5 grand, then that way I'm more than
okay.
I should be covered.
And then the last one, indirect. Those Brenda.
Administrative indirect.
22 is okay.
So I draw. So bear with me half a second. So that last one we just did, we went from 8,000 to 5,000.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
So reduced it $11,500.
Yes.
So and now.
So whatever that comes to. 480 something or other, 490 something.
502-125.
11,500.
What do we reduce it by?
11,500.
Brings it to 490-625.
490, 490-625.
490-625.
If are there any more questions on this? Do selectmen or do you guys okay with this?
Yeah, we were just. I mean, we want to go along with the recommendations of our committee, so I'm fine. Trevor, are you fine?
Yes, I'm good.
Kip,
yes.
Obviously you're chair of the committee, so you feel comfortable? Okay.
For the finance committee, I'll make a motion we authorize a $490,625.
Second. It's moved, seconded. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Is that unanimous?
Yes.
Yes.
And
when
should we vote this as sewer commissioners or select board?
I think you're right. I'm going to go bring in...
As both the sewer commissioners and the board of selectmen.
I'll be back.
All right. If there's no further discussion, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay.
When did we do it as both?
490-625.
We did it as both, okay.
490-625.
Okay.
Kevin.
Sir. I'm going to shoot you an email asking when we can get together, okay?
Okay, no, that's fine.
So you know.
Yep, no, great. And again, you know, I, like I said, I'm just... I don't know which direction we want to go in, you know. Like you said earlier, because I know we've already gone past this, there's some things we can, there's some things we can change up, you know.
We're getting there.
And reduce it down. You know, if this is just my own personal opinion, is if we're going to go for the Mass Works grant again, I would go for this. But if you don't get the Mass Works grant, we can do this. And one thing, and again, I'm going to throw this out real quick, because I want to have somebody else that's got a PE stamp to absorb this theory, is the retention time of what he has up there is killing him, because it goes from the tank down into that small little clarifier, those two short little things that are what, probably all about 10 feet long. He doesn't have enough detention time or retention time. So he has to put a boatload of chemical in there to be able, so when it goes out into the river,
Puts a dam in like he did.
Right.
To slow it up, to create a head.
The other theory that he had, which is kind of a cheap fix, is if we go a little bit further off to where, you got the two tanks over here, you got the driveway here, and you got that little shack. If you go just the other side of that little shack right there, we can put in a pond. Drop a pond, 3.5-foot pond.
We can do a recycling, put the clarifier back into it,
and then
recycle it back in. You don't need to put it back in.
But if you
the mosquitoes will be terrible.
Get off, man.
What mosquito?
An open pond.
All right.
Yeah,
you would be
on a pond. We don't have mosquitoes here. Troublemaker.
All right, thank you.
Have a great night.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good job.
That was just a wastewater. That's all we're doing?
Yeah, it's good. Yeah.
That's all set for a long night.
Wow. We've got a meal.
Yeah, wow.
We bring this another.
We'll keep it.
Oh, you know,
I should have. Do we watch TV?
Well, I'm not back.
I got a show.
I could have made it.
Now these I just gave everybody on Tuesday with that little small bunch that I handed out. You got those right?
328.
I did not put yours in your book because those are the last ones we did. Just yesterday, right? Yesterday,
yeah.
Tuesday.
Yep.
Yes.
Exactly.
Wow.
It's been a long week.
I'm trying to get the
I handed you when I came in.
No, I'm just saying.
Here you go. Do you need a copy?
Of course.
You can have mine.
You can ask.
See, I'm going to give you everything.
I handed you when I came back from being out there.
I have this, but it doesn't have skins in it. It's on your last page 4.
Never mind.
Would be a special art.
If I take 2,000, that's what I think I need to do.
You
can
do this.
Yeah, I have a duplicate.
You should have one dated 328.
This is 328.
And it should be on your page 4. That's your income. So page 4, there you go.
Okay, are we all set?
Yeah.
No.
Are there any other witnesses to that
event? Zach, in looking through, talking with Brenda earlier today, we looked at the salaries, and for your paramedics and EMTs.
Yes.
And we had some questions on those. It looks like they may have been underfunded. So I'm going to have Brenda get together with you and
okay.
Oh, okay.
I don't want to go through them tonight. It's just,
okay, I think you and Wendy went through them, right? Together, the individual, you're talking about the individual salaries.
For the new class comp or the...
The new class comp.
So whatever it is, I just want you guys to take a look at them and make a decision on it. And whatever adjustment has to be made, has to be made.
Okay, yeah, we'll double check.
Okay. All right, so having gotten that one, Blue.
And I apologize because I was not, I just got back into town. So what,
some people bring cash for a raise.
Skip, what line item are you talking about and what amount that you're talking about?
Well, mostly it's full-time, it's the full-time base.
Full-time staff salaries.
Yeah, full-time staff salaries.
And what were you talking about, the 378,005 was underfunded? And by how much were you saying?
I don't know. That's why I'm saying...
So we just want to check, okay.
And I mean, we're not talking $50,000 or anything like that. You know, it's so...
Not quite accurate.
Okay.
If Wendy and Brenda and Zach can take care of that.
Yes, we'll get together and check it, okay?
No problem.
The concern was, it was a $50,000 increase in total salaries and you didn't have an explanation for that. And salary line item went from 656 to 707. So if it's underfunded, it's going to be higher than $50,000, so.
$8,000 of that is the director's salary.
Only eight, but there's only nine employees, so.
No, I'm just saying of the 656 up to 707.
And this is full-time staff salary.
Eight of it is the director's salary.
Okay, we'll check that.
Skip has a copy of it.
I know, we couldn't read it.
Yeah, I could print, do you want me to print you?
No, we'll go with this. You guys get it taken care of. Again, you know, for example, one of the first things I saw is, I'm guessing, that somebody's being paid $2,404 and they're being raised next year to $2,427. And that's the first paramedic one.
Yeah.
So if that's the case, fine. But if not, I just wanted somebody to check and make sure.
Yeah, we went through very carefully.
Make sure
some people have been around a few years and some are brand new.
Okay.
Who wouldn't get the same, so we obviously did that.
So Skip, you're right, that looks weird. We'll check that. Yeah,
that's all.
Yeah, that does look weird.
It may not be, there may be a good reason for it, but you know, I just wanted you guys to check it. I didn't want to spend a lot of time here trying to do that work, so. Okay.
Okay.
Just take a look at it. It's not worth chattering. What other questions did we?
On that line item, for the overtime, I know we didn't have one in the past, but is $70,000 seems to be pretty high. I know that we've been addressing that quite a bit. I don't know why it needs to be that high again.
That number's based purely on an annual estimate of 250 hours annually per employee for overtime, which works out to, it's like 3 hours a week on average. And that was just to cover holdovers, like late calls that might run an hour and a half, that occasionally happens. And that's how that number got to. It was a little bit lower initially than I consulted Kevin, talked to him about what he estimates for overtime as well, and that's just where that figure comes from.
So primarily that's if you're talking like if the ambulance needs to go to the hospital and the people are there and then they come back. It's not the scheduling issue that we're
correct.
Have.
Right. Yeah. Yep.
And that was all they discussed.
So these sheets which have the salaries, the overtime, we will Brenda will see if she can print them a little larger and we'll distribute them so that if you guys have any questions afterwards. Okay?
No. We had a question on medical supplies. Looks like it was listed twice, $13,000. Is that?
No, it's just that's a line item and then it's a subtotal.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Total of the line item.
So it didn't get.
That's what we discussed.
In other words, if I look down this, the italicized items aren't being added in. They're just a breakdown. Okay.
Right.
Yep. The director's salary, can we go back to that?
Sure.
I'm just curious what director for a three ambulance service gets in other towns.
I don't know.
You know, I mean, that's basically a step nine, which is, I'm not saying it's, you could be underpaid too, I don't know. I'm just wondering how we got the number. It's off the salary classification schedule, right? Mm-hmm. That's a step nine.
It is.
Assume so.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And I understand there's a personnel issue someplace in here, and I don't know what.
We're meeting with Bob Hearn Monday night.
Okay.
To discuss it. I mean, if we're going to go by the schedule, then we've got to bear to everybody.
So, does that mean it's not cast in stone, or it is cast in stone?
This is not. No.
You confuse me on that one.
Well, we don't. The issue at this point in time, or part of the issue, and correct me if I'm wrong, is that the salary for this year is not set in stone. The current FY17. So, and here we are, we're 3 months from the end of the year, and that needs to be. And I assume once that's, or let me put my 2 cents worth in here, once that's taken care of, then from that, we should be able to come up with the salary for next year.
So then the 78,104 is not a known number at this time. The budget may change, right?
Correct.
Yes.
Correct.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Okay. What else do we have questions on?
Vehicle maintenance. Health and safety is also liability insurance is a big one.
Well, the same with all of these things. If the money's not used, it just goes back into the
retained
earnings. There's keep my fingers off this. There's probably a good chance that the rent is going to be reduced this year. So,
which is, but we'll worry about that when we get there.
Yep. Yeah. Right.
It goes back into retained earnings.
They can use that to buy furniture.
What the other question we had was on
don't even go there.
Vehicle insurance, is that only for one? Did you find out if that's for one vehicle?
That is the
amount for one vehicle.
Yeah.
Correct.
So we need to change that, right?
That is for one Deerfield vehicle.
That's true. That's a good point.
No, that is a good point. Yeah, we bring two more. Over.
We did bring this up because
if
Sunderland and Whately turn over to Deerfield, then Deerfield will be insuring three vehicles.
Yeah.
And that isn't enough.
That's not in there.
That's not enough.
Well, whatever it is, there's probably enough slough in the budget so that we can get there. But yeah, that's the other thing we asked SAC to do, was to make sure that all the vehicles are under one umbrella. And if
SAC, when we get the new ambulance,
that'll be under Deerfield. Yep.
So
and then the last one still needs to be transferred. Yeah,
and
we're working on that.
Could be twice as much as what we have right now. So.
Or three times.
Right.
We don't know how much that is.
Yeah, so we don't know.
Do you have? This came up a little bit in the CIPC meeting.
That will be paid for. I'm assuming that we could take that money out of reserve, the $100,000 reserve.
For which?
For the insurance.
For the three vehicles.
For the three vehicles once we get them transferred over.
If they need to be.
Well, we're not putting in the correct amount of insurance. We don't know what it is.
What
if you would like to triple that, because we will be paying for three vehicles, you could triple that now, or we could.
We don't. Do we know we're paying for insurance now?
Yes.
$17.25. That's for one vehicle.
And we're actually paying that?
No, I think the cost, if I remember right, was like $471.
Right, that's what you said.
So, and maybe this is three.
So there probably is enough in there. If it's $450 or $500.
How can that be?
Yeah.
We have this one vehicle. You can look at the spreadsheet that MIIA gave me, but that's
what
they gave
me. They're only charging us $400?
Mm-hmm.
$480-something.
For one vehicle. One ambulance.
We have a huge fleet, so.
My car is more than that.
I was just
going
to
say
individual
cars. Not mine.
I know. We talked about that yesterday.
We'll put a spreadsheet in the back.
Yeah, a lot of this was discussed last night.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry.
You know, maybe we get a better deal because we've got this whole big policy with them. I don't know.
All right. Well, then maybe
let's hold on. Leave it.
We have a lot of vehicles.
Maybe that's going to be enough. That's fine.
How about liability insurance? That's only $200. That can't be right. I mean, we're taking people that are...
But we talked about that last night, too.
Why don't you go ahead and talk about it again quickly?
Yeah, so MIIA, I asked them to break it out for me, and they gave me a cost of $16. And they said that
it's
so much of it is wrapped up in the town of Deerfield that they really couldn't split it out. So that we discussed that last night.
Yeah, that's why you put the $400.
Should we have an allocation then?
You know,
I mean, why should the town of Deerfield pay for all the insurance for students?
$14.
Well, all but $400.
We do have an indirect cost allocation, and actually, I was looking at that today, and I'm thinking, well, okay, we're charging 10% of all these different categories to skims, and one of them is town office building maintenance, and you know he's using this little teeny office in this building. We're charging him 10% of those costs.
We don't need any more discussion.
Yeah. Okay.
So from another.
Good point. That's why I asked.
It's on camera.
So there's $63,000 that's coming into the town for indirects.
Yeah. Yes.
So that you know. One way or the other, it's close enough.
We're covered.
We were just concerned more than anything.
I just wanted to make sure it's actually covered.
Yeah.
Well, that's
so they are actually covering our insurance.
Yeah.
Even if they say it's a couple bucks, they are covered. All our EMS people are covered.
Well, I don't know because I've not seen the policy. I don't handle the policy. I just pay the bill.
Okay.
So,
you talked about it.
Yeah.
I'd like to know that we have professional liability insurance of some kind.
We do.
So that
we do, John. We do. But
I didn't see it last night. I was looking at the book.
Yeah, it was in the book.
For police.
No, there was also public officials and employees.
But it might be different, right?
I don't think that's a kind of a usually employee liability is like.
Basically.
You say something bad about some.
Okay, so you specifically want to know if we've
turn a stretcher upside down and something
they don't
bad.
Have a lit? You mean if they don't have a lit?
Yeah. If there's a patient in it?
Huh?
If there's a patient in it when they dump it over?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I think there's a lot of exposure.
Well, would you do me a favor, and not being funny, would you get together with Brenda and set it? If you're satisfied, I'm satisfied. So.
Is this the scams discussion?
I'm okay with the budget number. I'm concerned about our coverage.
Well, I agree. But what I'm saying is that if you and Brenda get together, or you and Wendy get together, I keep doing that.
I will check it out.
Carolyn.
I am a risk manager, or I used to be.
That's what we said last night.
So I will check with Brenda, and I will read the policy and make sure we're covered, because I absolutely want to make sure we're covered.
Okay. So, I told you she used to sell insurance.
Yeah, and now I believe you.
It's almost as bad as a used car salesman, isn't it?
No.
That's one step below.
Property and casualty underwriting certificate, even though it's 30 years old.
But they had insurance in?
Yes.
That's and when my they first
CBCU, cars. And it doesn't expire, so I used to be a risk manager, so I will look at the policy and I will make sure we're covered. Because I
want to
make sure we're covered.
Okay. Any other? Have we covered anything?
We covered everything we discussed.
Yeah. Yeah, there was one thing.
Look,
that
next to the low down. Go ahead. There was one thing.
Well, go ahead.
The question that was asked last night was, how are the reserves spent? Who has authorization to spend reserves?
So when you set up an operating reserve, I did get an answer today. When you set up that operating reserve for extraordinary and unforeseen, it's exactly like it is in the general fund. So in the general fund, any expenditures out of that have to be brought before the finance committee and approved. I don't know, we've always had the select board approve it also. I don't know if it requires that also, but it's exactly the same in the enterprise fund as it is in the general fund. So you could be assured that if they spend any money out of that, it has to come to you to be approved.
So there's a proposal made to, like for our reserve fund, there's a proposal made, we vote on it, so we're the same with schemes?
Exactly.
Yeah. Same process.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, there's one thing that you need to bring up so you understand what you got. I'm gonna go up to the board. Can I use the board?
You may.
Okay.
So if you can.
So this is FY18 budget.
$100,000 in reserve. The end of June 2018, this goes to retained earnings. It's not available to you again till FY 20.
I was understood that an account could be set up, so it would not go away.
Well, that's what.
Not in this case. It's strictly an operating reserve.
So it does go away.
Mm-hmm. Yep. It does go away. Yes.
So I would.
But you could also go to a special town meeting if you needed to. But
we could go to a special town meeting. So.
Either way.
My recommendation would be that you keep it in retained earnings. But that's not what you. And this is a question that I wanted to ask the board, which was the presentation that we got from Zach. We have all of the remaining retained earnings from 2016 being allocated in the 2018 budget. Why?
This.
Right?
Yeah. It's right.
So now what's the purpose of that? Well, as opposed to leaving it in as retained earnings?
The idea was that in previous years, right, we've been trying to chase what does that retained earnings represent. You know, we had capital rollover that went into retained earnings, and we're trying to say, well, that was earmarked for something. And
That one I do agree with. And
yeah.
We can argue whether we want 1 year or 2 year for the analyst,
right. So
we would do that.
So the idea was that to take that full sum that is certified as retained earnings and show what its intention was by assigning it two things instead of just letting it kind of float in the ether.
Now, did we get into a problem with that one meeting finance committee and it having it go away at the end of the year?
What's that?
The operation, not the operation, but the capital reserve.
No, the capital reserve would go actually into a capital project fund, mm-hmm. and it will stay there until it's spent.
Okay.
Yep.
So that 108, there's not a problem with it.
No, you can set that up as a capital project, and it'll go right into a capital project fund, and it'll continue to collect until you decide
until you
to buy
to
your
end. Right.
Yeah.
Now, what happens? The capital finance committee, the capital improvement finance committee, only voted one stretcher and not two. So, what happens with our capital expenses that we've allocated for two? And the Board of Oversight has recommended two.
I don't know how you present that at town meeting. Wendy, do you know how that would work?
I was trying to write down what you were saying.
I think you make a motion not to, as Skip suggested, to put all of the balance not being spent as a capital item into retained earnings.
Well, with the possible exception, the ambulance.
What other than what's being set aside into a capital account, which the $108,000.
Mm-hmm. Well, we need to sort this out for town meeting. So how do we do this?
Yeah, I don't know if you present what the CIPC committee recommends first, and then you make amendments. I don't know any of that. That's not my purview.
Well, it depends whether we adopt the new CIPC bylaw before we get to this article.
Yeah.
I don't know what past practice has been.
The new bylaw should not take.
I'm just kidding.
CIPC still recommends to the select board.
So it's the select board's ultimate decision.
Right. And town meeting vote.
Yeah. So then where it goes from there, I don't
know. Okay.
All capital items from skims are either lumped together or specific articles voted at town meeting.
So all the it was a recommendation by Joe Markarian, who did this review today, to have the operating budget in one article and then have all the capital items in the article with all the other capital items, specifying where they're coming from.
Yep. So then
I thought that made sense.
Made sense. Then whatever was not spent would stay in retained earnings.
Correct.
That makes sense.
Okay. Because, you know, someplace along the way, you're going to end up with retained earnings this year.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Or you're going to end up
right.
with money that's unspent to move into
right.
to retained earnings.
Right. Yeah.
So.
Plus 100. The question is whether you move the 100 into retained earnings.
On that operating reserve?
Yeah, if you take it out of the budget and put it in retained earnings.
Or reduce it, or?
Yeah, just leave it where it is.
Leave what it is, and yeah. It won't be available, well.
Well, if you put it in retained earnings, it's not
It's available through us, and then if it's not spent, then it'll be available until it's recertified.
That's true. If it would not be available, whatever it's in retained earnings on July 1 isn't available until it's certified. That part's true. So in that case, the 100,000 would be available. But you typically don't need it in the first 3 months. It's afterwards. Right.
Mm-hmm. What happens? What about? I'm going to bring this up. The furnishings for the building. So if we need to take money out of the retained earnings to furnish the building early on in FY18,
you have furnishings. You have $50,000.
I thought you had money in there.
Well, the CIPC didn't recommend it because it didn't have any specifics to it. It was tabled.
Well,
right.
Okay.
Well, it wasn't any specific.
The request was really for us to okay the designation of their retained earnings.
Right.
We understood where it was coming from, and we didn't have any objections, but we couldn't really vote it.
Right. So in that case, it would stay in the retained earnings.
Capital items.
So what's the process for
the Board of Oversight? Is going to have to, if it's a major capital item,
you have to go back. It's going to have to go back to a town meeting.
If you use it for a venting system, like $30,000, it goes back to capital. But if it's just for cleaning supplies and shovels for snow and desk and bed, that's not really.
You can't, but you won't be able to spend that. You don't have to use your reserves because you're buying supplies and materials and refrigerators, washing machines, whatever. But all that is not allowed yet.
Right.
Nobody's voted that retained earnings. All retained earnings have to be voted at town meeting.
So you would go to a special town meeting and have an amendment to your budget.
But you couldn't do that until after the DOR, DLS, whichever you want.
Not all of them.
Can't
put it in there.
Certified.
Well, the 75 is already certified. That still sits there.
On June 30th, it all goes away.
I'll go away again.
Until it's recertified.
Mm-hmm. So
retained earnings.
Just like our free cash.
Free cash. Mm-hmm. Retained earnings, they all go away July 1st.
So that was the reason why we were looking at the reserve, because that reserve account would go forward after June 30th. That's the only reason, and it may be a 1 year thing, or just like you guys have. I don't know how much you have in reserve. Some of them carries $25,000-$30,000 just for. That's why we.
Yeah. Well, the reserves I think are fine. It's just a question: you won't be able to spend that $50,000 in capital.
Right.
Well, because it's going to go away, I didn't realize that now it goes away in July 1st, and we won't get it back until September, October.
So why don't you put it in the reserves?
You've got $100,000 in reserves. You could use that.
Or your operating reserve, if you kept part of that operating reserve,
you could designate that
towards the supply.
Yeah, you just come to the Finance Committee and then we approve it or send
our cap approval. Depending
on the value, and you still use this. You still have to go through the Board of Selectmen and the Finance Committees to get it out.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It's a little cumbersome.
It is a little cumbersome.
The whole thing is cumbersome. But
what did you do previously? Now, I know you didn't spend.
We did.
Never had that problem.
No. Told the fire district bring in a new table.
Because that's we're
all.
Doing it right as an enterprise fund.
Well, no, but in the past we've never overspent. We've never had the need to, our expenses have always been under what was budgeted.
That's a good example to send.
Well, and hopefully we'll still will be. It's just that.
Yeah.
We're trying to do this, it's awkward because we're trying to move, buy equipment and stuff like that. And you have one group voting yes, and you have another group voting no, and it's a little bit difficult to figure out what we're going to do.
I thought everybody voted yes, nobody voted no.
I'm talking about the capital improvement.
What, on the 54,000?
On the
50,000. We didn't vote.
No.
The stretchers. We're talking about two stretchers.
It hasn't been resolved how we're going to handle that. Board of Oversight, which we are a member, or the other two members of, that has already been voted, so we're going to have to sort of...
But Carolyn, the understanding was you can bring that forward, right?
Because you're a financial member for...
Wasn't it understanding that you can bring that forward?
Yes.
As a select board, right?
It's just that it's awkward to do it, that's all.
I have a question. When the Finance Committee motions to vote on this, are we voting on the entire budget or just the Deerfield budget assessment?
The entire budget.
Entire budget. Then we also vote on Deerfield's assessment?
Well, we don't have to.
We don't have to because it's already pre-determined.
That's all part of it.
Right. So I make a motion that we approve the SCIM's enterprise fund budget, 500, I can't read the number.
516057.
1250202.
That makes sense. 1250202.
If you want to add to it, Deerfield's share is whatever.
267117.
The member assessment to the towns is 516057.
Okay, well, we do that or we do...
No.
We do this.
You should do the budget. I just do the budget.
That's fine, because the motion...
Total operating expenses.
Will be the total budget, and then it'll be split up accordingly.
By revenues and assessments.
This makes sense.
And actually, we'll do that on town meeting floor, when we indicate that.
Okay, so the motion's on the table.
Second.
Any further discussion?
Yeah, would you repeat the motion?
Motion is to approve SCIM's enterprise fund budget for $1,250,202.
$250 or $229?
I was told $250,202.
Correct.
$250,202.
What's your date down here?
But that's got the $100,000 in it.
We're leaving it in.
This is the more...
I'm leaving it in, because it's the only money we have access for 12 months.
I'll second the motion.
It already is seconded.
Oh, okay.
It's moved, seconded. Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Is that unanimous? Is there...
Any opposition?
Are all those opposed? No one's abstaining, so it's 7-0.
Okay. Would you make a motion for the select board to approve this?
Sure. I make a motion for the select board to approve the SCIM's enterprise fund for fiscal 2018 of $1,250,202.
I'll second the motion.
Is there any further discussion?
No.
Hearing none, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Just one question. If the salaries do increase...
We'll just take it out of the operating reserve number?
Okay.
Is that what you're thinking?
I don't know. I'm just asking.
Is that...
That was what I was thinking.
Yeah, we're probably... We can't be talking...
If it is off, it's not going to be fine.
Yes.
Okay.
And if it's off by a whole lot, then we'll come back and we'll argue about it then.
Just wanted to be clear.
Tom, you haven't said anything?
I didn't need to. I just wanted to be here to support our... I wanted to support our director. I think he's been doing a very good job. I mean, there's a lot of learning. All of us, not just Zach, but all of us are learning. I appreciate the fact that Jeff and other members of the Finance Committee, Bruce, have been coming to our meetings and understand how we're working. I think that helps also. I think there's a fair discussion. And eventually, sometimes we're going to have to learn how that retained earnings, we're lucky to get it there. We took a little bit more off the assessment this year.
We appreciate it.
Which is very nice.
And that should help. And hopefully after we get 3 or 4 or 5 years of revenue coming in, we'll be able to budget better. Because I'm sure, Mary, when you were there, just like Brendan now, it's difficult when you don't have a lot of history to go on. And we're starting to develop that history. I think we give better numbers to you.
Yep.
We have much better numbers. From the numbers that we got from you know, the insurances and the workman's comp and the disabilities and all that, we're getting better numbers, so we're able to give a tighter budget, and we understand where those numbers are coming from also.
I'd also like to thank the Board of Oversight for their efforts in that, and I really do believe we're heading in the right direction with this service.
to bring service.
Part of it is just trying to work out the awkwardness of everybody having to prove everything, you know, multiple town approvals and going, you know, having the Board of Oversight then having to go through Deerfield procedures.
Sounds like schools.
Yeah.
It's awkward.
The only other thing, I think we have a capital expense budget. Do we have to recommend that?
I think so, yes. It's separate.
Capital expense for skims?
So.
I thought you were done.
Sorry. Can't let you go yet. So, the only question I have is, now we have a difference in the recommendation. Do we need to address that?
Probably. So, what's the Capital Improvement Committee recommending?
We already approved the 108, I guess you could say, right, over time.
Yeah.
The 21 was approved.
Yeah.
The 50 was approved for 25. The 54,260 we did not vote on because it wasn't capital items.
Understood.
The stretcher was, instead of, there was two requests for two stretchers, so that all three ambulances would be outfitted with the stretchers, and the Capital Improvement Committee only voted for one. Zach made the presentation that he, you know, to have all three ambulances outfitted so they could rotate usage. And rather than me summarize it, Zach, could you just go over that? Why you felt it was important to have two instead of one for the finance committee?
Oh, sure, yeah. So the idea is that we currently operate with three ambulances. That's two for, to cover all of our emergency calls, and then we have that third in reserve for, to either cover broken ambulances or additional calls. And we try to maintain all ambulances up to the same standard. So it's consistent training across all three units for all of our staff. And in that way, if we do have an ambulance that goes out of service for routine maintenance or whatever, we can choose from any of the other two ambulances left to then take its place. And that way we keep the stress on the truck, the wear and tear on the trucks. We get to even that out so all the trucks are consistent, which would mean that upgrading to this standard for the power load stretcher should be done for all three units, not just two of them.
The stretcher has a lifespan of 15 years, and as a risk manager, my recommendation is that we approve both of them because the
You're making a recommendation for the select board?
Yes, I'm making a I'm just talking about it in general, but I would make the recommendation. The select board has already voted as a boo to forward this, but I am saying that the recommendation is to do both of them because the risk of injuring our employees and having workers' comp claim, like today, Zach, you can mention the
We had an employee sustain a injury on duty yesterday that could have been prevented with this very system. So,
and potentially that person, even though they didn't want to be picked up, could have fallen and sued the town. And it's a huge liability issue not to have this structure. It's a huge liability from an employee point of view of getting injured, but also the patient. And in this case, the patient was arrested, so he didn't want to go, but if he had fallen and gotten hurt, you would have believed that he would be the first in line to sue us. So
the patient got arrested? Is that what you said?
Or he arrested, which...
You may have read about it in the paper.
It was in the paper. It's public information. It was I
don't care about that, but I'm thinking that if you're worried about liability of him falling off a stretcher going into an ambulance, opposed to liability getting stuffed into the back of a cruiser. I don't get that.
Well, he still has an expectation to be treated compassionately and appropriately by EMS staff, and that includes dropping
the cruiser
him.
The cruiser doesn't have a loading system, you know?
I'm just saying that.
And also,
He got dropped.
So the new ambulance has this in it. You'll get it with this in it.
Correct. That was included in the price of the new
ambulance. So the backup ambulance, if we accept the
capital improvement committees, the backup ambulance will have that in it as well, and the third ambulance would not.
Correct. Yeah, right now that third line truck is actually what backfills our first line truck, because the third line truck goes out the least and the front line truck goes out the most. When the front line truck goes down for service, we actually take the third line truck and move it up, and that keeps wear and tear consistent across all three vehicles.
How difficult is it to move that equipment?
It's permanently installed in the vehicle, okay. But it would move to a different vehicle if we... Yeah,
it's installed.
It's installed, yeah.
So even if it's 2 or 3 hours, it's still 2 or 3 hours.
It would be beyond our ability, yeah.
The the firm that you're buying the new vehicle for is going to install this on the other two vehicles?
It will be installed. It's in addition to this.
Yes.
And so the weight issues, and there's no weight issues?
Nope.
With it?
Nope.
So what do we have to do to keep this to 50 instead of 25?
You just have to vote 50.
No, remember, ours is a recommendation for the town meeting, so just basically the same.
Same as us.
Same as the capital improvement committee. All right, somebody make a motion.
There's one other item. What are we going to do with the last item in the expense, 54,260? Are we taking that out?
If it's not a capital, it should. The question is, what should we do with it?
Do nothing.
Leave it in retained earnings?
Mm-hmm. That's fine. And then, you know,
mm-hmm. And use the reserves for the...
So we need some math.
We need to change the reserve to 150.
Well, take 54,260 out, so that would be... Take 53,180, 179,000. What's that?
Yeah.
Make a motion to approve the SCEMS capital expense budget for 179,000.
And that includes two stretchers?
Which would include two stretchers.
Okay. Second.
Let's move second. Any further discussion? 179,000 as opposed to 233,260.
One of the things that somebody didn't see, was only a couple of us watched over there, was the potential savings on the workman's comp, which will more than pay for the second one inside of one park in 5 to 6 years.
Yeah.
I know I have had a back injury for 40 years. I did very little to do that. Mm-hmm. And, you know, nobody needs it. You know, it sounds like a joke until you've had those problems. Mm-hmm. And it's a lifelong thing. And, you know, and for especially when there's a savings there that's going to pay for itself in such a short period of time, I can't not see funding it.
But it is the backup ambulance.
So, pardon?
It is the backup
ambulance. It is the backup
ambulance. The backup.
And I understand where the Capital Planning Committee came from. They were introduced with a number back in December. And I heard those arguments.
Yeah,
and
I agree.
And you know, and I, but I, you know, this is a major safety issue, so I would have to support.
We all agree. So let's move the question.
Yeah. Well, no further discussion. Good vote. All those in favor of 179,000. I'm sorry.
Yep. Aye.
Aye.
All those opposed?
Opposed? I can't.
I know.
I'm not going to go back on what we said earlier.
No. I have to abstain.
I'm going to abstain.
Two abstentions.
Two abstentions.
One's in opposition and one's in.
Yeah.
One abstention.
5-1-1.
5-1-1.
No, it's 4-1-2.
Skip them.
I abstained also.
I'll make a motion to approve the SCEMS capital expense budget for FY 2018 at $179,000.
I'll second the motion.
Is there any further discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Thank you, guys.
Now. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for waiting.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you. Thank you for coming.
Thanks, Tom.
Exactly.
Do you need to
stick around?
Yeah,
I appreciate you coming.
Do you know
two nights in a row.
That's
what I'm here for, right?
I don't know what they want to do.
Well,
yeah. I have a
and we'll check the those employee numbers. I think we're fine. I think I know where the confusion is. I think we're fine. So we'll double check tomorrow.
Sounds good.
Okay.
Thank you.
Should be in by 10.
All right.
There's one here that.
Thanks, Tom.
Thanks, Tom.
I don't know when we got this yesterday. Good to see you. Energy committee.
Yeah, we we put on hold.
We put it on hold.
Oh, I thought you killed it.
Energy.
So we're curious to what the selectmen.
Actually, we voted it down.
I did my best to explain.
Three, four, zero.
There isn't a number. This was given to us yesterday.
The account number.
There isn't an account number.
$182,500.
Yeah, 182 is up there. Correct.
Okay. I wasn't the
same with all. We didn't vote it down. We didn't vote.
Yes, we did.
We
voted it down.
I know that we.
I got 3-4. Yeah. 3-4-0.
So I just wanted the selectmen to
I did my best.
Throw in their 2 cents worth.
This is the energy committee. The energy committee asked for $1,000. This is partly to follow up with the infrared work, and I did my best to explain that. And,
what's $1,000 for?
That's for the mailings and
transportation
plans
to go down to Dunkin' Donuts.
Nothing.
Educational materials and that. I asked them to give me more detail with that. That's
Well, basically, there's a company out there that has volunteered to drive up and down all the streets of town and do an infrared survey of all the homes and provide all that information to the tenants for free. But they only wanted to do that for free, knowing that the town would do something with the information, like forward it on to the homeowners. Then, you know, if they do nothing with it, well, that's limited. And I guess I assume that there must have been some cost involved. I thought maybe we could put these in with other bills that we send out anyways, but
That was the opposition, at least my opposition, to the use of the data. Who was disseminating the data to the residents? I didn't feel a committee should be having personal data and disseminating that to back, putting it in an envelope, addressing it, sending it to somebody at their home.
It's nothing more than an infrared picture. It has nothing else on it. It has nobody's name on it. It just has an address and a picture of the house.
So what's the use of your mailing?
Because the homeowner will get this and they will see where the house is glowing red, knowing that they have a problem
with
the lack of
potentially
insulation.
Will be.
Well, the windows, but the roof, the eaves, and all that stuff. And that all it is to show people who don't know where their house is leaking. This will show them, you know, oh, geez, I got to have more insulation in the attic. Or
are they doing this from the road?
Yeah, they're not going, David. They're just driving up and down the road.
So you're only going to get one side. Can't do my house,
nope.
Really.
No. Right. It does. Yeah. It will do three sides, and the computer will, you know, figure out what the back does. You know, it's not an exact science, but it's pretty darn close, you know.
Mass save will do it for nothing.
No, they won't.
No, they don't do infrared.
They won't.
Well, we're doing this for
the energy audits.
No,
maybe
not the infrared.
Mass save.
We talked about this last week.
No, not infrared, but they'll come in and do an energy audit.
Yeah, save
right.
Years.
And that problem is, as I said in the meeting last night, one of the reasons this is a whole project that Senator Rosenberg has gotten engaged with, and the Greenspan Foundation is funding it. And he invited four towns in his district, and there were some others in Hampden County, other senatorial district. We're also doing this. And part of the reason behind it, the reason why Senator Rosenberg was very interested, was Mass Save works for some people, but it didn't do me much good. I've had a couple of those done over the last year, 20 years. And they want to look at these other options for better ways to spend some tax money that goes into these energy audit programs. So that was, you know, impetus for. If you have something more to say about that, you were at the same meeting I was.
Right. No, and I agreed. And basically, it only costs us the money to get it to the residents.
If I receive a picture with no explanation and have no idea what infrared means, and it shows a bright spot, I think without showing an example of this is where the issues might be in your home.
It does say that. I mean, I was being a bit vague, but it's a picture, and it will say, you know, where it's from, and, you know, it will have a little chart.
And say, these are the issues we find at your house.
If you have blah, blah, blah.
It's more generic. It has like a color graph saying, you know, the yellow shows a heat loss, and, you know, the blue shows a colder area and stuff like that. And you can tell, I mean, the way they do it is pretty good. You can even tell if a furnace is running in a house or has been, because it will change the color of the chimneys and stuff like that.
So these would be coming individual by address.
Yep.
And then the responsibility would be for us to just mail them?
Yeah.
All we have to pay for the postage?
Either pay it for the postage or add it to...
And the energy committee is going to actually do folding of the paper, mailing it.
Well, it seemed like it's a job that would be done in part of the town administration.
Regardless, shouldn't we cover some postage?
Well, I don't understand why the energy commission needs to mail these out. Unless they're going to do a narrative, an explanation, and say, here's where funding is, this is additional funding sources, and you might...
How about we have actual cost, and they come to you as the finance committee for a reserve transfer? You don't want this as a reserve transfer project? You don't have a line item for this now?
What I'm concerned about is, it's $1,000 that they're proposing this year. What's it going to be next year?
Oh, no.
This is supposedly one and done. I've heard one and done many a time, though, before in this town, and it doesn't happen very often, one and done.
So we're usually...
This is just a one shot deal.
Actually, the committee did not, finance committee did not recommend it.
Correct.
So it's your vote, your recommendation.
Okay. Well...
Are you changing your mind?
If somebody wants to change their minds or
somebody
wants
can make
to
remove it,
then go ahead.
Right.
Make another motion. That's not a problem.
It's fine. So, but can I just get more of the questions? Because do you feel that last night you got most of the questions?
Trevor.
So did you get most of the questions that they
no,
had?
No, I wasn't at the presentation when the tip were at, but I think it's a any way we can learn how to save energy in this nation is a really good thing. And if it costs $1,000 for stamps to go out, I understand Bruce's
concern. That's
actually
for their whole year budget. It's not just this project. It's other things they want to do.
It would be nice to have. I mean, I don't know if we have to approve this tonight, but it'd be great to have a little letter from the energy committee to say, these are the items we'd like to spend $1,000 on. It just says miscellaneous expenses.
Well, we can vote it as long as, and then what? But I want it, what I wanted to do is, if we vote it, then we have to defend it on town meeting floor.
Right.
So what I want to make sure is that you had enough of an idea of what the questions were and the concerns.
There were privacy questions, which I understand.
Right.
And there were questions against, will this affect my house when I get it appraised in the future or go to sell it? That's a valid question.
This is a public record.
Public record.
Is it a public record?
Yeah.
No.
It's not a public record?
It's not a public record.
So no one will
know. No one has it afterwards? No. Okay.
Oh,
we'll get one copy of each house, and that's it.
Okay.
And then who keeps that? Who has the data that they have? They wipe it off their computer?
Oh, I don't know.
This is exactly what I'm saying.
Yeah, but the thing is,
somewhere down
with what they're doing, they don't need permission. They can do it anyway. It's a rooftop mount thing, and all they're going to do is ride up and down the streets. They're going
to. I don't care what they're doing.
We just want to get the benefit.
They're only doing it to benefit the homeowners. So all they want to know is they'll do this as long as the town will get it to the residents.
Okay.
You're actually asking questions I asked as well. So I just want to let
you know. Okay, no, but these are good questions, because we need to find the answers out so that we can talk about it. So what were some of the other concerns that you had, maybe? Because that was a good question.
I think the privacy issues were the primary concerns.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so we definitely have to check that.
The other question thinking about it, is that we need an explanation on if there are issues with your home and you verify, you've got all yellow, all of your house, what do you do?
That's up to you to do with it.
Exactly.
That's up to you.
Why are we spending money?
We're not spending money. That's what I'm saying. If, I don't know what...
We're not going to educate the public, why are we spending money?
This is their whole budget for the year. It's not all of it's attributable.
If you guys want to vote this down or not vote for this...
We've already not recommended.
All right, and that's okay. We're still going to get these pictures anyways. How we get them to the people is, we'll just figure it out.
I already know what's bad in my house. What's good and bad.
And my wood stove is going to glow like the night, nightlight.
I use my driveway so I can get my house.
I make a motion from the select board to approve the energy committee budget of $1,000 for $2,000.
But I feel like them too. I want to know what it's for too. It ain't just...
Well, why don't we table this, Trevor?
You know what I'm saying?
Let's go do something else then.
Okay, we'll table this and get an explanation from Mike. Okay, we'll get it before we go, before we have a final...
Money is the...
Well, it's...
The bond accounts?
It's no explanation, I mean, there's no explanation.
This committee has had money in the past. I guess not this last year, but I knew when I was here before, they were... I actually came to your town meeting before I started as the intern. They had a huge table with all kinds of materials, maybe some of it was free materials, but they used, you know... They had some resources to...
I would say the energy committee needs to kind of come with some information. We've got a blank page, it just says $1,000 this year, like they've never done anything in the past. We had some support, that'd be great.
And that's why we're going to table...
I don't know, the furnace is going.
Yeah, but...
They can say, look, you need to work on that.
They've already made it.
If it's not going, hey, it looks good.
We're going to table it because we have no information.
Doesn't make sense.
So we'll get, try to get...
Message for that is put in electric heat so you can't tell.
If it's on or off.
Or electric heat won't show, you won't have any furnace blowing out there.
We don't even know if that money was earmarked to mail those.
The coils being hot.
No, it doesn't, it's not that fine.
But it was good to have...
You can't see through the wall. You can only see the heat loss from the building.
Can we discuss sort of very quickly here, I know it's getting a little later, but a couple of things. Free cash, and are we going to be attempting a capital improvement budget? As far as...
Capital stabilization budget?
Capital stabilization budget. Are we going to be trying to address that this year?
I have it on the warrant.
It is on the warrant.
If you want.
Don't we have to see how we're meeting proposition 2.5 first?
Well, there are some other, yeah, there, we should see that, but I would like...
I think you're running the numbers, we'll show it.
We'll need to do that, but I would prefer not to do that at this meeting. I would like to talk about the acquisition, property acquisition next door.
So...
Are we going to do that in executive session or not? I don't care.
I don't know how...
Acquisition for...
I don't know what you want to say.
Now, with that change and with the capital for PEG, I'm showing that we're spending...
It should be discussed.
$764,000 out of the $1,585,000.
I'm not talking about free cash, I'm talking about proposition 2.5.
I think the formal votes have to be taken in open session.
Yeah, but this includes, this is your revenues, all of your revenues.
Yeah, the vote, the final vote.
The final vote, but not initially.
Not the discussion.
This is the operating budget?
I don't see why you need to go into executive session.
This is the revenues that we should...
No, but we need to show all the...
Executive session, we need a roll call vote.
And this should...
For every member to go into and come out.
That's the total.
If you make any motions, that has to be a roll call vote.
Including your special articles.
Negotiating.
Right.
So it includes wastewater treatment and scavenging, everything, so hopefully...
That's the money we're going to spend.
If the subject matter...
Somebody knows something that...
Plus what I said, I added...
If the subject matter is a subject for executive session, then we're sitting here discussing it, then that kind of nullifies the executive session.
So it doesn't include any stabilization money.
You're going to notify if you're going into...
So this term, I don't believe that the finance committee has...
$2.5% of that.
As an advisory committee really doesn't have a role, but the select board decides that the purchase exchange and then local...
Okay.
If you, an open meeting may be detrimental effect on the negotiation.
Anything else that you forgot?
No, that's not covered there.
But not, you know, I don't think it applies, but I could be wrong.
Don't you have to put it on the agenda that you're going to?
Sometimes you don't know and...
You can, one of the reasons to go into executive session is to consider the purchase, exchange, lease, or value of real property. If the chair declares an open meeting may be detrimental to effect on the negotiating position of the public body.
So that's.
We're not really negotiating, but.
Well, you are in negotiations.
Well, you are, depending on what, if there may or may not be restrictions.
Okay, then I will declare it, reason for executive session.
I can write it down.
And number six, Trevor, do you, would you make this motion? Yes, because I declared it, right?
I'll get it in a minute, so you're going into executive session for that reason.
All right, then just, you could, do you vote yes?
Number six. You can read it.
This here?
Yeah.
Do you have a question, Kim?
Yeah, what are you doing?
We're going to go into executive session.
Oh. We can discuss.
You're going to read that to make the motion.
Do you have to invite us to be in it?
Yes. Or no, they don't have to.
We don't have to.
Sorry.
But we're going to invite.
Wanted to make sure if we were.
So I make a motion to go into executive session for reason number six, to consider the purchase, exchange, lease.
That's a good excuse.
Value of real property.
Thank you, Brenda.
Chair declares.
I did declare.
You did declare. Aye. McDaniel?
Aye, yes.
Aye, Henry Camosa.
Okay.
We also.
So are you going to?
Chair, you seconded, but you were going to invite.
And I'm inviting the finance committee to discuss.
And do you plan to resume the executive session?
No.
No.
Would like to.
So now you got to shut off the camera.
Show me the warrants and draft warrants and talk about that with you.
So we're going to skip, open up.
Do you want to go over capital?
Because we want to actually post it next week.
Okay, then we'll have to come back into open session. I guess we have.
We should go to vote again.
Executive session.
For the finance committee?
Yes.
Make a motion, we adjourn.
We have a motion, we have a second, all those in favor?
Aye.
We adjourn.
Finance.
701.
If you have any questions about the warrant, please contact Wendy. Trevor, do you want to make?
Wendy, I'm going to send you an email asking for when we can get together about the future capital needs.
Hearing none, all those in favor?
Aye.
Before 10.
Huh?